What's up, guys? I'm Grant Thompson, the King of Random.
And I am Stuart Edge. Today I'm the Apprentice of Random.
There you go. And today we're taking some copper tubing, cutting it up, throwing it in a backyard foundry to see if we can liquefy copper. The purpose of today's experiment is to melt down some copper. We've played with metals like aluminum, brass. They have a little bit lower melting points. I've never done copper before, and so I really want to know if does this backyard foundry actually melt copper. So I got Stuart Edge and I got a dull hacksaw blade. I'm gonna put him to work chopping this copper up into little pieces, and I'm gonna go fire up the metal foundry and see if we can get this to work. Copper's pretty expensive stuff. I went down to the Home Depot and picked up these 2-foot lengths, and they were almost $8 each. I got four of them because I'm not exactly sure how much copper we're gonna get, but this stuff is pricey. We're gonna reduce it from a stand down into a little ingot that we can work with a little bit easier. We're gonna do that using this bench vise. This is gonna be a team effort, Stuart.
Yeah.
Dude, you just took that out. No time flat. We got the hacksaw master.
Here we go.
Master Edge. Can you use your back for leverage? This is like yoga. I'm just not that flexible. How you doing?
How am I doing, Your Highness?
It's looking good to me. Let's
your
see.
Your Highness.
The spoils of our labors right here.
Yeah.
Check this out. Stuart, you're doing a mighty fine job, my friend.
Thank you, thank you.
Ready? Ready? Here we go, watch this. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? I don't even know where it went. Where did it go? Oh! Quick update, guys. We got everything cut. How does that feel weight-wise?
Probably about 1.5 pounds. It's like a box of butter.
Copper's a relatively heavy metal, especially once you shrink it down in size and make it an ingot like we're about to do. Not so heavy when it's in tube form, but very heavy once we can globulate it together and make it into an ingot. What you're looking at right here is about $30 worth of copper. People legitimately make businesses out of scrapping copper, like wires, tubes. This is like plumbing line. If you salvage that and take it into a metal recycling place, you can make money recycling copper. Exactly.
What about pennies?
Pennies are zinc. They're just copper coated.
Okay.
Zinc's pretty worthless. Now the reason we shrunk this down in size is because when we put this into the crucible, we want more surface area exposed so we can get this melting. Once we get a little molten pool of copper, it's gonna be a lot easier to start melting the rest of it. So smaller pieces are gonna get the process moving a little bit faster. At least that's the idea. Now in yesterday's video, we tried casting metal fidget spinners and we made ingots. We've got some leftover junk in our crucible, but we're gonna set this down in here, fire it up, get it nice and hot, and I think that's cleaned out enough that we can get relatively pure copper. All right, I'm gonna give you the barbecue igniter. I'm gonna go pump in some gas.
Okay.
Here we go. Whoa! I was waiting for that. I was waiting for that.
You're yelling at me. It's like, oh.
That is awesome, dude. Nicely done. When you're hanging out with the King of Random, random happens.
That was crazy.
Were you expecting that?
Well, a little bit. My mind was like, this is gonna go big. But like, no, Grant wouldn't just like have me light something and have it blow up in my face.
Okay, so we're just gonna take that lid, throw it on top. So quick update, guys. Our furnace has been running for about 10 minutes now. The crucible is glowing red hot. So it's time to take the lid off. And we're gonna start throwing these things in one by one.
And see if they melt.
Now, copper like this has a melting point of almost 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, something like 1984 Fahrenheit. So the purpose of this experiment is to see if this backyard foundry gets hot enough to liquefy copper. I've never tried anything with a melting point this high. But if it will, it will also melt gold, silver, and everything else because they're all at the same melting points. It won't do steel, but it will do everything else. So this is the moment of truth. This is where we find out if our crude backyard foundry that took 10 minutes to slap together is robust enough to take down copper.
Whoa!
Look at that. All the metals from our previous burn are like boiling in there. We've got fire, vapor, zinc fumes burning off. All right, here we go. We got our first piece of copper ready for the drop. Let's do it. Nice. If it is going to melt, I'm thinking probably in the next 30 seconds or so.
Could it explode? Is that a possibility?
I don't think so. I'd be highly surprised, but I wouldn't rule it out. Oh, look at that. The copper is changing color now. You can see it's starting to glow red. That's a good sign. All right, that thing's getting pretty hot. I'm gonna press it down for a quick peck. There we go. Look at that. It just flattened right out. It's not melted yet, but it's pretty dang hot. So let's put the lid on for a second. So I just put the lid back on so we can contain some of that heat, because as it's open and exposed, the air gets to it and cools it down. Our copper is so hot, I could flatten it out no problem. So I'm thinking, I'm actually very hopeful that this is gonna work, and then we can throw in the rest. Oh, look, whoa! Look, it actually is liquefying. It is liquefying. Look at that. Oh, where'd it go? That's really hot. Okay, this is gonna work. Let's throw in a bunch more.
Okay.
Let's get like, I don't know, 10 pieces in there. Here we go. He scores! Nice shooting, Tex. Oh!
Is that bad?
Let's see if I can get it. All right, there we go. We'll give that a few minutes. So here's the deal, guys. The copper is gonna be so hot, we can't use a traditional muffin tin to use as an ingot mold because it will actually fuse to the steel. The temperature ranges are so close, they'll bind together. So we have to find some kind of improvised way of making an ingot mold, and that's why we're bringing out the sandbox. The reason we're using sand is because sand is mostly made of silica, which has an extremely high melting point. Okay. And even if the ingot did stick to it, we could just brush the sand off.
Wow.
Dual purpose, let's get busy. So we've got a flat, sandy surface. Now I'm gonna take a spoon, I'm just gonna carve out little ingot molds that we can pour our copper into. Should work in theory, right?
Yeah, in theory.
So now, hopefully it all stays in one piece. We can do that.
That's scary. What if it was like falling out?
Then it wouldn't be very good sand.
Yeah.
I'd have to make some more. Or add some more water at least. There we go. Improvised ingot molds out of sand. Oh yeah, it's melting. Oh gosh, that's looking good. Okay, we got some slag in there obviously. We're gonna be very gentle here. I see some liquid, it's looking good. And we're gonna make the pour. Liquid copper, my friends. There we go, this is working. Beautiful. Okay, so I just knelt down on some kind of slag and it burned a hole right through my jeans there.
Whoa.
It felt like kneeling on a rock, except it started burning.
Oh, wow.
These things are still fiery hot. Look at the way it's still glowing orange. It's incandescent. It's actually emitting light at this point.
These are cooling down pretty fast.
Yeah, just about 30 seconds ago, these were glowing orange.
Yeah.
And you can see they're already turning kind of like a charcoal gray color. Yeah. That top layer is probably oxidizing.
Can I touch it now?
No. Can he touch it now? Let's grab a piece of paper and see exactly what happens if you do touch it now.
Okay.
Yeah, it's on fire.
Wow.
Just like that. 1 second, ignition. Pretty sweet, huh? Yeah, you see that? It makes a little rainbow, like little metallic rainbows. Sweet stuff, dude, sweet stuff. Here we go. Ooh, that's looking good. Nice and hot, hot, hot. Here's molten copper, everybody. That is looking good. Look at the way the slag floats on the top. It's good because it'll be able to scrape it right off. Ooh, that is beautiful. There's actually not a whole lot of slag in the copper, it seems. It is, I don't know where it is. Clean. Here you can definitely see the difference. These are glowing orange and actually emitting light, and they're extremely hot. I can feel the heat rating right there. Now you can see these ones have been sitting here for a little while. They've cooled down quite a bit more than these have. These are still a bit shiny, a little bit glossy, and they're very, very hot. So I'm just gonna use these tongs to dig down into the sand, pop them free, and then quench them in a bucket of water. Yep, they've definitely hardened up. And there's our makeshift ingot. Oh, that is a cool noise. That sounded amazing. Oh wow, look at the color. Look at that color change on top. It's like fuchsia. Cool, let's grab the next one. Grab it while it's hot. Look at the way that changes color. That is interesting. You can see how cool this system is because not only do the ingots not stick to the sand, but we can very easily move the sand back to the bucket and reuse it for another casting. At this point, these ingots are cool enough I can grab them by hand. I'm just gonna use a little wire brush here to take off the sand around the edges. Just clean them up a little bit. You can see they very nicely took the shape that we carved out with our spoon. Little copper nugget. And here's the finished result. Four little copper nuggets, which look absolutely like the holes we carved out in the sand. It is interesting, that magenta color on the top though. It's very pretty. So this is pretty exciting for me, guys. I know other people have melted copper before, but this is the first time I've tried it for myself, which means our backyard foundry is getting well over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit to be able to liquefy this stuff. And this means now we can cast things out of copper, which I think is very exciting. The other thing I thought was interesting and kind of a coincidence, we had four stands of copper pipe and we made four makeshift ingots. It also means these are worth about $7.50 each. This is super good news, guys. This means our metal foundry takes down copper without any problem at all. I'm very excited about this.
What are some things you can make?
So what do we want to make out of copper? We could really make anything. I mean, fidget spinners were going to be the original idea, but I think that trend has kind of played out. Yeah. Copper's heavy and it looks cool, so it's really just a novelty casting things out of it. Put some suggestions down below and maybe we'll use our green sand and make it happen. And a big thanks to my friend Stuart Edge for coming to hang out today. Stuart, it's been good having you.
Thank you so much. I'm glad I moved from apprentice to hopefully court jester or peon or something like that.
I think we're all learning something new here today, and we're glad to have you along for the ride. Go check him out. He's Stuart Edge on YouTube. He's got good family fun. He does street magic and all kinds of useful, wholesome pranks. So go check him out. But anyway, guys, thanks for joining us for this experiment. We will be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. That was awesome! That moment when you smell the burning nostril hair in your own nostrils.